Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the session of Dynamics of Machinery. Now we'll be starting with the unit number 6, that is Introduction on Noise. So let's talk about some basic of noise. So the learning outcome of this video is student will be able to understand the source of noise and its effects on human being. So let's understand first what is noise. So there are two concepts basically, sound and noise. So here are the two images. So the first image shows you that in our daily life, we hear the different types of sound like singing of birds, some music, rain, communication, telephone ringing, transportation. So you can say sound is a part of the life, part of your everyday life. But sometimes this sound creates an irritation to the person. So here in the second image, you can see that some type of sounds can create an irritation to a human being. So the sound which creates an irritation is nothing but the unpleasant sound. And the unpleasant sound or unwanted sound is nothing but your noise. So sound is pleasant to hear and noise is unpleasant sound or unwanted sound. Basically, you can say that what is noise? Noise is nothing but a wrong sound in the wrong place at a wrong time. So the example for this I can give you is, like, suppose if you are very very happy and you play some music in your house and you enjoy it. So when you're enjoying it, it means that is pleasant to your ears or it is pleasant for hearing. Okay, so this is the sound. But now, in second condition, consider that you are very very tired. You have came from your job or from college and all, or from somewhere outside. You came and you are very very tired. And at that time, you want some peace. But your neighbor plays this music and that sound becomes unpleasant or that sound creates an irritation to you. Why? Because at that time, you was needing rest or peace time. So same sound, when you were happy, it was pleasant for you, but when you were tired, it was irritation for you. So that is nothing but wrong place, wrong time, and wrong sound. Okay, so noise is not always about intensity, so it's based on human tendency. So noise is harmful for human beings. It leads to loss of hearing. It may damage the hearing system of human being. Also, it leads to loss of memory. It affects communication. In a noisy area, persons are not able to communicate properly. So, effective communication is not there. It reduces the working efficiency of the human being. Now, annoyance means irritation. It's not always that same sound will create irritation to all. Like, take an example, like music which is pleasant for a girl, that will create an irritation to the grandmother. As there is age difference, so intensity of hearing the sound changes. So irritation is for grandmother, and that is that same sound is pleasant for the girl. So this is how you can compare that what is noise. Now let's talk about source of noise. First is industrial noise. So these three images shows you how the noise is generated while welding, while lathe machine, or due to various assembly work, and also due to various testings and all, the noise is created in the industry. The next is home appliances. Noise due to home appliances like mixers, vacuum cleaners, washing machines, this creates a noise. So next is construction equipment. Here you can see stone crusher, digging of floor. This creates a huge noise. Then noise due to rail, air, road transportation. So this also creates a huge amount of noise, which becomes an irritation to the persons who are nearby it. So now let's see the range of noise level. So here you are seeing various industrial machineries, and here are the ranges of decibels. So for industry machineries, the ranges start from 80 to 125 decibels. like lathe machines, furnace, fluid pump, they are having or they generate low decibel noise. Whereas press machine, sheet metal forming, dropper, hammers in forging. So you can say press machine generates more noise over here. Then next is home appliances. So range of noise level is from 35 to 88 decibels. So refrigerator, cloth dryers, air conditioner, fans, vacuum cleaners and all, food blenders. So here are the various decibel levels. The next is construction equipment. A range of noise level in decibels again. So from 65 to 100 decibels. So various construction equipments are there. So rock drills, pneumatic wrenches, scrapers and graders create maximum noise over here. Now actually you have to consider the distance measured from 15 meter distance. This decibel levels, whatever I have shown you, it is measured from 15 meter distance. As your distance varies, your decibel will vary. So if suppose there is a compressor now who is generating the decibel that is 65 to 70 decibels. So this reading is came from when we are measuring it at a distance of 15 meter. If I am going at 25, then this would decrease. And if I am going to 5 meter distance, then this decibel would increase. So normally we are considering as a 15 meter distance to measure the decibel levels. Now, human audible range is up to 130 decibels, no doubt, but till 85 decibel, it creates a less irritation. So beyond 85, that sound becomes an irritation to the human being. So here, exposure of limit matters. Even if the human tendency is to hear the sound up to 130 decibels, but it is not like that a person can hear the 130 decibel continuously. Okay, so there is exposure limit. So if a person is dealing with 90 decibel sound, then he can work for 80 hours continuously. Then for 115 decibels, simply 15 minutes is 15 minutes are sufficient. More than 15 minutes will be harmful for the person. So this is how we have to deal with the decibel and the exposure limit. So let's talk about industrial noise. As an engineer, we have to deal with an industrial noise. So first is industry noises due to continuous machinery noise. So various machines we have seen, and the noise is generated from various machines like riveting, press machine, lathe machines and all. Next is impact of working tool on a workpiece, like in press machines or in forging, impact of working tool is on workpiece, so it creates a huge amount of noise. Then flow of work induced noise, like assembly lines, so due to various fitting operation noise is induced. Then repetitive actions and testing of machines or engines, this also creates a noise in industry. Now this becomes very very hazardous to worker. There is a chance of permanent hearing losses, improper communication, working efficiency, stress, irritation and fatigue. So workers are dealing with this type of harmful effects. Now how it is hazardous to organization? First is compensation claim. Now suppose worker is suffering from an hearing losses due to working in industry. So the organization has to bear the compensation burden for that employee. The next is productivity. Now, as we are saying that working efficiency of a human being decreases in a noisy area, efficiency decreases, its performance slow down, and also it increases the error rate because worker is not able to concentrate on his work. So ultimately it affects on productivity of the organization. Hearing protectors. Now there is always need to provide some hearing protectors to the workers, but again this creates a disturbance or discomfort to the workers. So workers are ready to noise rather than that disturbance. The next is medical surveillance Clients. Now, actually, when workers are working in such a noisy area, so there is a need of annual audiometric testing. So this testing wastes a lot of money, and also there is a loss of production period. So productivity affects and cost increases. Then there is a risk of accident. So in such a noisy area, due to less concentration, less efficiency, so there is also a chance of accident. So this how noise affects on workers, organization, and also on the surrounding areas. So industrial noise control becomes a very important point to be considered under our study. As we are studying dynamics of machinery and we are dealing with vibration, and vibration is a source of noise. So whole study becomes very, very important. So in my upcoming videos, we'll be dealing with industrial noise control. Thank you. For any queries, you can contact me on my email ID. And if you have liked my video, kindly like, share, and subscribe.